right, hello, goblin farmers. Barnacle here, and time for another episode of our farm build on Elm Creek. Where's this thing? Here. So let's get on with it and see what we can do. See what we've done already. I remember where we left off. Here. All of these mods. Figure out what we want to use and what we don't want to use. I just want to make sure precision farming is not loaded in yet. Nope. I'm not sure I'm done with everything that I want to do as far as the fields go. And then it'll be on with the show. So I think I decided we are going to play relatively as hard as we can. And as realistic as we can with regards to your precision farming. We're going to use Maze Plus. We're going to use the animal mod that creates the animal feed, and the animals eat more grass and more feed. What else? Anhydrous ammonia to go with precision farming. Dry corn for any of the corn that we're going to do. And what else goes along with that? We're going to play with rocks on. We're going to play with weeds. We're going to play with plowing, periodic plowing. We're going to play with all of those things. And we're going to work on getting the highest amount of yield possible for everything that we do. However, with that being said, this is also not going to be a cheap old starter farm. So the plan is pretty much have all the equipment that we could need or we may ever need. So I started doing some decorations. I mean, I bought some equipment. I think I did that in the last live stream. So what I started doing is just buying some big bags and put them out here. So whatever that is, fertilizer. Yeah, solid fertilizer. This is wheat, oats, it's herbicide or something. No, solid fertilizer too. I got some pig food over here. This actually is pig food. And then this is a Doika chicken feed pallets. And then so I'm gonna put some more in here, which I got over here. And I think I'm just going to auto-load them onto this truck and drive them over there, so I have to move not as far. This is the 82 Studio Mac. Obviously, it's a Mac truck, and it's the one that works with the TLX. Well, it says kind of right up there, right? Lizard Logistics TLX flatbed is what I have on the back of this truck. So you can use all the TLX X2 mods on the back of this truck. And I'm using pretty much most of 82 Studio stuff. And I'll show you guys as I go along all the different packs. But I like the trucks that with the changeable backs. Most of the time I just have one truck with each back on it. But I like that because I also have the this truck, which is a TLX. This is a 2020 Trail Boss. Kitted out in the Kubota skin. And of course you can put any back you want on this, but this is just gonna be the farm truck with the gooseneck attachment in the bed. And then they have the 2022 edition, but it didn't have the Kubota skin, so I wanted that. I also have loaded in the 1982, I think it's 1982 version of the pickup truck, and then also the 3050, like the bigger pickup truck. That comes in single cab and crew cab with all the different attachments, and then the big X2 TLX truck. So to go along with this truck, I also installed Universal Auto Load Pack or mod. that way we can actually load up pallets like this. I think it's left shift R, yep. And then load them all in there. That's pretty cool, right? And then it'll actually auto unload too. And it double stacks. Oh, we might be able to even pick up these guys. So we don't have to come back. Ah, we'll just. I'm gonna bring those to the other side. Oh, yeah, got all of that stuff. I didn't want the other liquid. These liquid pallets. I'm gonna bring those to the other part of the farm. Put those somewhere over there, but in here, I wanna put these guys. And you can come right here, and you can do Shift I, and it'll just unload them. Pretty sweet. I think so, anyway. Makes life a little bit easier if you're not really wanting to do all the pallet stuff, which we will do, you know, use a telehandler and all that stuff once we start farming. But in the decoration mode, it's all about super strength and stuff like that, right? So we're gonna go ahead and move this guy over here. If I learn to push the right buttons. I think this green Doika pack. I thought I had pioneer seeds. Pioneer seeds. I forgot how to rotate. Oh, that was apparently not it. Okay. Super strength. I really don't like super strength outside of doing this stuff. Here. You have to push the button. Bumper. So you put this guy here. Something like this. Just something to give some decorations, right? I had two of every color. Here's this one. Actually, this guy doesn't have a friend, I don't think. Put him up here. All right, something like that. Good. So this is a. Okay, so I don't really know how to pronounce it. Obviously, it's German or something, but I would say Doika. Something like that, maybe. You can look it up. But anyway, these packs all come with the... Oh, yeah, here's a pioneer seed. Come with the Mace Plus. That guy. This guy's here. So you have all of the Maze Plus stuff. So Maze Plus, plus the animal grazing mod, plus the animal food mod. It makes them eat more food, more realistically or whatever. Nice, that can go there. Oh, there was two of these. So let's... this guy over here. Maybe under the window. I like the packaging too. It's pretty nice. So I'll put those there. Just trying to fill something in the barn so it doesn't look so just so bland or whatever, right? Inside. So again, maybe over here. Put these two guys over here. So my plan is obviously not to use any of these seeds or liquids or anything, right? They're just decorations. Hello, farm kitty. What are you doing? So something like that, right? Then still gives room for. Let's put another one of these. Actually, let's put one of these in here like this yellow. Under the stairs. Like falling through the floor. Weird. Okay. Two more. Actually, I don't even. I could just use the probably easy dev controls or something, right? But so I got rid of the yellow one. So let's load the yellow one in. I mean, basically, I'm doing that anyway because I'm using the money. Let's just put a set of those, maybe some pallets of this silent cat. Can't load multiple. Four of those. Alright. Where did that go? Love how it did that, right? So basically, it knows how to stack, right? But that means we will be able to get them all. That's good. Loading the areas full. We stack the back one. Okay, be difficult. We'll bring this over to the other farm. The other, it's the animal area, animal husbandry area on the left, and then our main farm here. Maybe we can pick up our bales. And I was thinking that we put them maybe in this shed. Sort of spread them out. Let's see, what do we got? One, two, one. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13 of them. That means number 7 is the middle. Actually, let's put the additive Okay. Yeah. No. Put this here. Hopefully those can stack. And then there's four of these, so two on each side. Put him in here. This one here. The red one. Down here. Alright, so let's just put some decoration in here. Sugar beet stuff over there. There's some, a couple more TLX trucks over there, one with the Homer attachment, and then the other one is the Winter Wolf. He's set up for snow plowing and stuff during the winter. And load all this stuff up. That's all you can fit on there? I get a different trailer. You gotta be kidding. The little trailer I was using held more than that. Actually, the auto load trailer for this truck held more than that. There's the main entrance to the homestead. Got the horse barn here. This area to fill in too. What we should put in here? Should we put hay bales in here? Like hay decoration? Whatever. This is straw, right? But I guess yeah. Let's put some in here. I mean, this stuff we could potentially use, right? Because I already have. We farmed it up. Put a few bales in here. I mean, I have a bunch of. Come on. That's what I don't like about super shrink. Very good at it. Or if it pushes right through the wall, annoying. Not supposed to push through the wall like that. Something like that. We have four. Oh, my skills, probably. close. I don't know, I'm more in the middle though. See if I can move the whole stack without it. Create a crash counter. Seriously, dude, what are you doing? I can't believe you can only take four. There's even, you even have the extended thing on the back. To load those into the hay or whatever, straw, you know, bale or shed or whatever, but might as well use it for decoration while we have it. You can always get more straw, because actually I think I have collect straw swath on contracts too. Are working out okay. My leveling skills, maybe not so much. But yeah, area block. I might take this trailer. I might sell this trailer back. This is a gooseneck trailer too, but. Counter number three. You're like, you're telling me you can't use this one? I'm fast as hell. Thank you. All right, so now we can finish this. We'll do 4, 3, 2, 1. Your pretzel anymore. Must have the volume turned down on my end. This. These ones we put inside. So obviously this stuff not very interesting to most people probably, but I've never really done any of this before. Most of the time I just go in and start playing the game. I thought it would be interesting this time to kind of set up a farm, look the way I really want it to look. Like the heart to start a whole new series, you know? Just be like, yeah, this is kind of what I'd like a farm to look like. Like basically, sort of if money was not really an object. Like have all the equipment, you know, most of the equipment. But we are going to create a massive debt. So I started messing around with the XML. I didn't even know you, like, you know, I wasn't sure how I could do it. But you can actually play around with the XML and of course I don't necessarily recommend that to people that don't really understand how XML works, but being a coder, I'm comfortable with that. But I mean, it's very simple. It's basically just edit and save, right? Just don't delete things you shouldn't be deleting. I don't know, maybe let's stand this guy. Okay. Easy. Not bad. Pretty happy with that. So, actually, I'm gonna save where we are now. Right. Oh yeah, I was gonna show you guys that too. So if we go up to the bank, so I was messing around with it, but you see in the red. I was able to change the amounts, right? Like how much we spent on new vehicles and land purchases or whatever, that kind of stuff. What I'm trying to figure out is if I do that, like if I take out a loan, but for some reason the borrow part is blocked out. So I downloaded a mod that said, increase your loan to 10 million or something. The ability to take out a loan. So I have to look into that. But if I can make the loan say something like minus $5 million, right? The loan is 5 million, and then we have say 3,500 in or 3,500 in vehicles and 1,500 in buildings, and then our cash. Let's say our cash is 100,000 or something, 50,000 maybe just 50,000. But we have a huge loan, but we have everything we need. The farm is just super in debt, and we're going to find some way to get the farm out of debt. And so, on hard economy, right? So that's the plan. So I was thinking when I added the minus 5 million and the minus 1.5 million or whatever, that actually that was the loan part, but that was just like spent money. So hopefully there's a spot. I would assume there's a spot in there somewhere for loan amount. But yeah, I didn't get it. Then I was thinking, I don't really know how to do this, but let me see. How do you spawn in stuff? Add bales? Square bales. I think these were 180s that we have here. Unwrapped. Hey. Then how do we do, like, how many? Object build types. Oh, tip to ground. Add pallet, add bale. Remove bales, remove pallets. Tier to area. Add log. Yeah, oh, one. Oh, so I just have to do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, something like that. All right, all the way to the sky. This is hay, so we're just gonna put one row of hay in here. So 4, 3, 2, 1. That's what we're gonna do. So I thought those were 180s. Are these are 180s? 9,000 liters, 6,000 liters. So the hay I could have made bigger. I guess we used the bigger bales. I thought we did the 180s, but don't remember? No. Being that the horse barn is right here, that'd be kind of cool to have some of this stuff in here. I wasn't gonna use it for tractors, but I don't really need it for that. Camera collision. That's the problem. It's like you run into the building. Oh, good enough farm work. Sort of cattywampus. What else can we put in here? We got square bales. We can put some round bales. Round. Square. Round. Only, I guess only be, oh, maize silage. Yeah. Do they have square maize silage? Whole crop, grass, crop swath, straw, hay. That's it, right? So those are silage. We could put silage bales. This is whole crop silage with maize plus is the new, like, regular silage. Let's put a couple round 180s maize silage. Those are big. See what those look like. Oh, I could have did wrapped ones. That would have been. That's what I should have done. Right? Maybe we'll put some of both in there. More. Nice. Let's just do a couple wrap, I guess. They have to be 150s to wrap. Oh, no. Oh, I just... We can't wrap. Can only wrap whole crop. Conditioned grass or whole crop. What about square? Okay. Let's do a couple round 180s, whole cropped, wrapped in Kubota orange. Awesome. Farming Innovations orange, shooting orange, vet red, case red, massy red. No Kubota, huh? We'll pretend this is Kubota. Let's do 1, 2. Let's just do 3, maybe. Let's see what it looks like. So 1. Oh, yeah, they're small too. So same size. But we just want to, just a couple in here. Just to get the idea. Something like that. Cool, just gives us some decoration in there. Inside of here, we can put some pallets of horse feed. Can we do that with? Like, I don't really know how to do all this stuff. Pallets, farm products, seeds, soil, fertilizer, lime, liquid fertilizer, herbicide, mineral feed. I'm not sure what that looks like, so I'm just going to do the ones that I want to do from here. It's only money. I just fix it into XML. So I want to do the one that look like Doika. Right, so that's cow, chicken, pig. See these ones, right? So I don't know how many we want to put in there. Let's start with two of those. Then there was another one. Cow. That's horse. Beef pellets. Do a couple of those. PSP. Find here. So there is a couple big bags. Right, that has them. Just this one. Put a couple of these in here. Only ones? Doika ones, I think. Yeah. Doika ones for horses. Hey, cow. It looks just the same though, right? So it's no different look than this one. Same. All right, so just use this guy to get it closer. I should have moved the store delivery dealy. Oh yeah, let's not hit that. Let's just drive over this since there's no crop destruction on the grass. Got some anyway. Dang it. I only picked up one though. Oh, probably that's as close as I thought it was. Oh yeah, I gotta fix this field. Because I did find out that you definitely need to put in the meadow grass or whatever in there. I don't know if this one is set up right or not, but I read that if you put meadow grass in the field, then the animals will then graze on, right? So, these guys? Could put some in the front up here. Through the floor. I wonder if that would work. We could like fill it up like that.
Pretty cool.
Finest oats. Horse fodder. I love it. What do we got going on here? We got this horse. put it over there. Horse trough. These guys, maybe we'll put. Doi Cavallo. That's just a little something. It's not just a plain old barn full of equipment or whatever. Right? That's acceptable. Something like that. What I started doing, or I thought was a good idea, is to also get like this and that other one, white. Sort of put it here as a like display of what's going on. No, the other way. I think that's cool. That's kind of what I'm going for. And I think maybe that could potentially be enough. I don't know what else I'll put in here. Saddle stuff, some feed. I got some feed up there. Got This guy. Go back in here. We got hay. Hay's for horses. Where's my... Oh, hold on a second. I don't have my drink. Can't live without some water here, boy. Whew. All right, so we got hay, straw, silage, that kind of thing. Good enough there. This barn's full. I mean, not full, but you know, we can put some implements or something in here. I just don't know what. On the second floor, this barn is actually where the loose straw and hay or whatever is stored. So that part's cool. Just drop it over here and pick it up over here. Nothing in there now. Silo empty. We got a bunch of pallets in here. So I could do the same thing here with those bags, individual bags. You know, or maybe even lean these ones like this up against the thing. I don't know. Just like my steering. Can't make enough fine tuned motions. Oh, yeah. Why can't I take the top one? It's kind of weird. This one fast, that's probably being held up. Oh, yes. Always something. Nice, nice, nice. I mean, you know, sort of defies physics there, but whatever. We got all this stuff, silage additive, liquid fertilizer, silage additive, herbicide. Thing of water. And diesel fuel. 1,500 liters in each of those containers. So I like the look of them. Those are cool. I don't know what else. What else could we add? It's just a shipping container. Bales. I don't think we need that anymore. Well, these ones are. We did one of these in the other barn. Did I have room for that left over there? I also have this big pallet to put in there. Where else do I, like, I don't know what to do with this whole part of the barn. I haven't really decided what to put in here. I mean, I could put a big trailer, a couple big trailers or something. Kubotas, one's behind us. So we got the M5, M6, and M7. No, M6, M7, and M8, I think. The two McCormicks and the Bent Black Beauty, which is like 464 horsepower. The McCormicks are like high 200s, low 300s, and the Kubotas max out at 200. So we have all the implements. We got a seeder, both the corn seeder and regular seeder. We got the fertilizer back there, and then also a sprayer there for liquid herbicide and liquid
fertilizer, I guess.
We decided to use that. Well, until we get slurry and manure, we're gonna have to use that until we get animals. There are three greenhouses there, and then I changed up these silage bunkers. Are the ones that come with Maze Plus because they were a little bit smaller, and I could fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in there instead of 3. And you can actually dump, you know, we could put in each one because, you know, Maze Plus comes with all the different grass types now. We have, you know, they can go in. Why is there a big hole right there? What happened there, dude?
We gotta fix that.
Definitely. I can't see it. Landscaping. We'll work with our water tanker there and our tipper, and then flap it here. We got the big Volvo silage rake wheel loader, the biggest wheel loader I can find in the, you know, main part of the game. So now we have a flatbed, tipper, and a water tank. Over here is our garage that has a snow plow with a salt thing on the back. Beautiful work. PLX Phoenix. It's the Winter Wolf. See the wolf right on there? It comes in bright orange. I almost was gonna leave it like that because that's pretty sweet. Orange color. And then this TLX Phoenix is the Detroit Diesel one, I think, with big Homer auger wagon on the back. And then, you know, our workshop. So I leave this bay empty for the workshop, but I'll park these two guys in here. Over here, we have solid fertilizer container with 10,000 liters. That's all that's in here. This is our multi-food sell point. Or not sell, but buy point. So we can buy pretty any single thing we need on the farm, pretty much we can buy there. I think it's 75% the cost of the normal shop. So there's a little bit of a discount there. We have the propane that's empty, which I'm not entirely sure how to fill yet. And then this is for our corn dryer. So we put our corn in there, plus we fill it up with propane, and then we'll get dried corn out. So 500 liters of corn gives us 500 liters of dried corn, but we are spending 24 liters of propane to do it. So our three greenhouses are ready to go with water, but I haven't picked what we're going to sell yet. Well, there's four, right? Because, yeah, there's one. Technically, there's one. The one with 20,000 liters is over by the greenhouse. And again, the greenhouses don't matter as far as size. I think they all don't. Well, this is a modded one, so not the in-game one. But I think the in-game ones all produce the same amount. It's just they hold more water. I don't know. That I gotta look into. Yeah, so we got all those guys. We got all that. What else do we have over here? Well, we got our anhydrous ammonia right here. Back here, we have the Homer sugar beet cart or sugar beet harvester. This guy here. I thought Homer had also a potato one, but they didn't. So we've got this Grimmy. Big old potato harvester apparently does everything when you're harvesting. And then I have this Grimmy big old potato, potato or sugar beet cart, right? Tipper. It holds, I think it's 34,000 liters or something like that. Got all of our planting is done. We got our giant silo system over there, which does, I think, holds 18 million, I think, liters, something like that. This one, I forgot how much it held, but this is just dried corn there. Got a little decoration from Elk Mountain Modding. Got our bridges. This side we have our overflow pastures that are good. I filled them up with water and no food or anything. And this is our main cow pasture here. Also, actually, I don't know if I did fill it up with water. The pigs apparently don't get anything. Well, I guess they get food. Dump it here, but whatever. We got this empty shed. Oh, we put all of our animal stuff here, so like maybe our animal transport, the TMR mixing wagon thing. Maybe we'll put some of that stuff over here. We got our two sheep overflows, one here, one up there. We have the slurry storage. We have the empty shed over there too with three bays. Slurry silo storage. And then our main sheep pasture here. I need to get out of here. We'll turn this off. Wherever the sign is. Oh, okay. turns off the blue area. See, I put meadow grass. See, this is the regular grass. I put meadow grass in here. This is where the sheep are going to graze. So I think that works out. And then we put the overflow in here, like the newborns and stuff like that, right? The ones that we'll end up selling. So I fill this up with water. See, I like all these little decoration things. Like, that's what we need. We need some, like, what is this? Just like a saddle? We need some barrels and buckets and shovels and things like that that would be cool around. Even some of these troughs or something would be good. Yeah, well, that's it. That's pretty much the entire barn. Okay, time to turn off. Track clean. Thank you. I don't understand why that doesn't work, but time's coming out of easy development tools doesn't allow me to use my controller. All right, so this way. I could probably put some chicken feed back here too. I didn't even think about that, but you know, the ones with the chicken feed picture, but we could put some of that back here with the dog who is always missing. I'm gonna turn off this marker. These chicken will graze back here. Got our house. This actually worked out pretty good. So I don't know, anybody who watched the first episode knows that this tiki torch, but actually it looks like a big giant arrow stuck in the ground. But assuming it's like a tiki type torch, because there was a big campfire here, like you're supposed to hang out around the campfire, able to paint over that, but there's no way to get rid of this tiki torch thing. But it actually fits sort of the aesthetic, just ended up being right there. Pretty cool. Added that decoration and that decoration and this house, but they're all part of the same pack, right? From Elk Mountain. Pretty nice. As long, also with this stone path. Like, that's why can't we have more like textures like this instead of just, you know, give me more paint textures. That's what I want. The garage also comes with it. It's a separate tool. Separate placeable. But yeah, I got the Kubota pickup truck in there, and then this Kubota 4x4, like the Gator thing or the Mahindra thingy. But I like this pickup truck, right? Trail Boss. I actually want one myself now. So you got a door that's usable, and then two garage doors also usable. This is the greenhouse I was talking about, which the idea of this is basically just to be, you know, for farmhouse usage, right? Got that Zetor tractor for decoration, really. This is the bale shed that I was going to put those bales in, but they're sitting over there perfectly fine, so I'm considering maybe getting rid of this shed. Not that I would know what that I would put there instead, but I kind of like the idea of putting the bales sort of in a place like we did over there. And I have a couple sheds, right? I have that three bale shed over there, or three area sheds by the animals over there that I could fill up with bales. So I don't know if I want to keep this or not. I thought I did in at first, but now I'm thinking after placing the bales that we just placed, I kind of like the idea of doing that. This just has auto load and auto unload bale feature, which is kind of cool, but I don't even know what it would look like. I wonder if we could. I'm not really sure how to get rid of it. If I drop them in, I don't know how to. I haven't really learned that yet. So yeah. that's pretty much all there is. Close all of these doors. I mean, I don't even know what to put in here yet. I'll have to kind of figure that out as we go along. Well, I should put something in here. Maybe we could put some trailers, like a horse trailer in here. You know, just like this, even though we're not really going to use it, right? But maybe we'll put the bigger one. Maybe we put all three animals. This one from LSF Modding is a farm kitty. Hold 6 horses. Chickens. This holds no horses. That one holds horses. That holds 2 horses. That holds. Attention. Can you purr on the mic? Rooker would like to hear you purr, probably. Everybody would like to hear you purr. Rooker would like to hear you purr. Alright, so anyway. 2 horses. Pull behind the pickup truck. Can you color this? Oh, yeah. Can we get a Kubota orange? Close enough to that. Wheel set up. Standard. I mean, almost not even really for use, but mostly for decoration. I'm gonna go ahead and buy that. And then also this 5th one. Can't change the color on that. Gonna park that in there. Then also this bigger one for the cows. So 6 cow, 12 cow. Where are you going? See ya. Bye bye. Twelve cows. Or 5. I like this. I mean, it was stupid that, right, that you couldn't put horses here, right? You can put big old cows, but you can't put horses. I thought that was kind of stupid. 38 sheep in there, but only 12 sheep in this one. 13 sheep there. So I think we need this. Could pull it with the Mac. I think that would fit in that long part of the trailer. Let's just go ahead and get it. Then figure out how we move. So right, we put the small one here, you know, small one here and here. And I think we could put the longer one in this first bay because it's over here, right? I think she can fit in there pretty good. Oh yeah, this one is the 3500. I completely forgot I had this. And this has, I think this is the feed wagon on here, is it? Oh yeah, it is, because you can see it up in the left. Top left, that it has the mixing ratio. So that's, that mixing ratio is, you see the recipe or whatever down here too, is from the animal feeding add-on, right? Part of the Maze Plus thing, whatever. So that truck, I can't pull that, but I can pull the, I can pull these two. Like this Mack truck is set up with an X2 hitch, so it doesn't even have a, doesn't have the other hitch on it. Fifth wheel hitch on it. Super Max. Standard. Change it to that right now. Transport vehicle, fifth wheel type transport. Nice. Oh, the trailer won't even fit in there. Well, that's a little bit of an issue. Where do you put that big old beast at? It doesn't matter. This is money. What do we care? Animal. It's just horses. This is just horses. But I could use that one from LSF modding. Use that smaller trailer. So we'll sell this one. Cow. Use this one, this beagle trailer. That's pretty nice, right? I like that one. Or it's this one. This one does 5, 13, 12. This one does 6, 13, 13. So about the same amount. We like better. The only thing I like better about this one is I can use the clip. Right? What I'm saying. Okay. What happened? Like, I just exited out of it. Doesn't think so. First team, fellow board. Why am I gonna pay extra? Cover H. Paint color. Or we can go red. Classic red. I like the subdued red. Match. It's not the same for beige. That color. Brown, beige. Those two match. Go with that. And open your door first. Can you do that from inside the truck? Now we have these three. Those are about the same length. The truck got dirty already. I just drove it out of the thing. I mean, I guess I could just really pull it right up to the edge. Farm truck to the rescue. Ugh. Tailgate. Inflow this. Inflow this. Where's the tailgate? Nine. That's pretty cool too. Love that. So it feels a lot bigger than the other one. Camera collision is so annoying. That's pretty nice. Oh, wrong one. I need to be back this way. See how it just, That animation was weird. Child just like cranks up the jack. Okay. One even blocks the wheels. Pretty cool. Tool is not compatible. Okay. Well, that had animation too. Wish that I could to hide the HUD, take that picture right there. I don't even know how to do that. Screenshot. Like, I don't even know how to do all this thing. I can play the game, but I don't know how to do all this content creation stuff. Gotta figure out all that. I love this look, though. The oranges are slightly a little bit different. That, I almost seriously want that whole pack right there in real life. Right? Two horse trailer and a pickup truck. Anyway. Yeah, seriously, I might get rid of that. This bale thingy. Let's put a regular, I can put a regular shed there. I don't even need it though. Really. I have enough shed. Same thing. Top tires. Now we got one here. Could even pull these up a little bit further and would maybe be able to put some gas in here. But we don't really need anything else. True, this barn has, oh, there's a light there. It's like, there's no light in this barn. So, we got this livestock trailer for the sheep and the pigs and the cows. We have this one for horses that we don't really put. We have this one for horses. You'd think this could hold more, but really, if you look, you can see right here, two horses, and then up here is usually like living compartment. Right. So you'd have a bed up there, right? This is like the pack room. This is the design. Just like literally the pack room. There. So those two racks over there are for saddles. And then, you know, hang the bridle and stuff like that up there. And then you probably put the hay or whatever you need up there. So it's pretty cool. I like it. Nice design. And we got this guy that can hold certain amount of animals. Got all of our bags. Everything. Alright. Got all that. Yeah, that truck is set up as feeder, so we don't really need, it's basically this one, but in truck format. So we don't really need any of those. We could need that's a water tank. I have a water tank. Water tank. We will need a milk tank at some point. So we could get one back. I'm gonna go put it over here. 8,000 or bigger. Set up fifth wheel hitch. Because also with the animal feeding add-on, I'm sorry, I don't know what the heck it's called. Also, the animals produce a lot more slurry, and they produce a lot more milk. So, that's important. My camera says. Let's see if I need to take care of it. cat just getting busy with the car, apparently. In the driveway. All right, so this tanker, although 32,000 liters of milk probably would be needed, I really don't like these dolly trailers, mostly because who the hell can back up a dolly? I don't even know how to do it. All right, it's crazy. I mean, sure, just one is okay to back up, but like when you have it attached to a second thing, no way, can't back up anything. Like I can't even back up the header trailer attached to the harvester. I basically just have to pull around because I can't get it to back up straight. So that's a skill. Can get that milk thing. I don't really like it though. See, I get one of these lizard ones, or these TLX ones, right? This one goes on the pickup truck. Can hold everything. Oh, I can hold propane in there too. So I could use it to hold propane. This is oh look, you can get an unrealistic quantity of 50,000 liters, so I'll probably do that. That's a trailer. And then this one, so this is for the TLX 2020 pickup truck, the one that I have, the Kubota thing on it. That's just a trailer, anything for that. And these, this one is for the 3500, like I have over there, with has this Coon feeder thing on it. So this, see this one? This one doesn't, won't allow the propane thing add-on part to work, but you can see this one has the red tank and the green tank, so propane and anhydrous ammonia can get filled in both of those. So that is interesting. And what is the blue? Is the blue thing for death, maybe? Not really sure. And then these guys. Yeah, so these are from DJ Modding, right? So those both 20,000, 10,000 liters will work for everything. I mean, these look pretty cool. With a little pump tank too, so that's pretty cool because if you're using pumps and hoses or something too, that would actually... That's the only thing I don't have added in. Because I haven't spent the $18 on it because I haven't decided if it's something that I'll ever use or not. I suppose if I make content on it, then over time it would be worth it, I guess. But anyway, so that's milk. Don't really need that now. We dealt with this. We could get into forestry, but I don't know what to do with that yet.
Oh, well, we may need one of these.
Which one is the heaviest one? 2.4 tons, 2.5, 3.2, 2.7, 2.9, this Weber, the heaviest. 1.8 meters, though. See, I have to hook that up to a PTO. I basically would want to use it with my loader. My wheel loader, right? Put it on the wheel loader because the wheel loader is heavy, and then this extra 2, right? I guess this 3 tons, extra 3 tons but it's all 3-point hitch, right? And I don't think wheel over. Her alone is 27.1 tons. I don't even think I need the compaction. What else do I have going on here? Low loader. I could use one of these guys to transport. You know what, that auto loader works pretty good. Nice long trailer like that. This lizard gooseneck is basically the one I got, but I got it with, I think I got it just bumper pull. Oh no, I got the TLX one, didn't I? The one that's actually on the back. Yeah, that was a mistake. I should have got this one. I mean, this 50 footer. So I can get this 50 footer. Bales, nurse trailer, standard. You see on the left over there, down there at the bottom, it says universal auto load. So you could actually use this long trailer. So it says it holds 30 bales, but also it has its own built-in auto load feature. But I'm thinking more like, you know, all those pallets and stuff that we bought that would load up in there. Auto load, we can move around, but trailer's so long, I don't really have a lot of long storage area spaces. So don't need that. Miscellaneous. I'm a mess. I'm tea packing. You know, that's a weight helps keep the tractor's wheels on the ground and improves its balance. A little strong. Some kind of weight. Oh yeah, this is all the Maze Plus Duca stuff. That's kind of cool. If we look into Maze Plus, is that in here? Yeah. So we see all the Maze Plus tools. So we got all kinds of stuff for grass work, right? So we got the subsoiler for grass. We got the mulcher for grass, which mulcher mulches the grass, but doesn't kill the grass, right? Like the regular mulcher brings it down to dirt. But this, I think, just mulches the grass. So that will work.
I don't think we need a baler.
I think the one I have will work. And then we use the auto loader to pick up the bales. Round or square wouldn't matter, right? All of this stuff we already saw, used. Carrot pallet, fillable pallet, potato pallet. Yeah, so I like the Doika trucks, right? That's kind of cool. It's just, obviously, it's a man truck. But it will go with the Doika trailer. Which, again, this is kind of weird because doesn't it seem like this would be a liquid trailer? Right? It even has the liquid out container things right there. But it says it holds wheat, oats, barley, canola, like everything, right? All the silage stuff, all of the grass stuff. What it doesn't hold is any liquids. So, to me, kind of a little strange. Not sure I understand that. But still cool. All right. Not sure what I need yet for belt systems. This thing, forge pickup thing, great. best investment ever. Buy one of those. Literally can put that in the front of a tractor. And you basically turn your tractor into a, you know, for literally a total of whatever, 200,000, you turn your tractor into a $500,000-$600,000 Ford Harvester. Like the Chrome Big Boy or something. Don't need any of that. Weights we need, but we don't know what we need yet. Don't need anything there. Don't need chainsaw. Don't need bell wrappers. Grassland care, we may need. Forge wagon. I haven't bought a forge wagon. Because I'm thinking that I'm going to bale. Probably bale all of the straw instead of keep it loose. Possum. That's the biggest one. 50,000 liters. And 300 horsepower. Silage additive. Yeah, right. So maybe that's something that we need. Straw and we add silage additive to that, which increases the input. I don't know. Windrower, we don't need. Tedder, we don't need. A mower, don't need, because we have all that. Planters, we don't need. We will need a roller. We don't have a roller yet. I think I'm more than happy with the 12 meter. So I should probably pick that up and put that with the rock picker. We don't need fertilizer spreader, sprayer, manure spreader. We have all that. Don't need slurry. Because we have a lot of tools that are multifunction. So, weeder. We don't have a weeder. Oh, but we're probably, we'll spray the weed though, right? So we don't really need that. We got a seeder. I don't even know what is a speeder. Subsoil, we don't need power harrow, disc harrow, cultivator, plow. We don't need any of that. We do probably need a mulch. Need a mulcher. 130 horsepower. 150 horsepower, Diablo, 5.8 meters, 6 meter Cancela for 200 horsepower trailer. What is this one? This one says 3 meters, doesn't say nothing. Cutter roller.
Do we get this one? 6 meter?
Yeah, I'm super tired today. Alright, I think we'll get this guy. And then right now we don't know how to do grapes, olives, cotton, sugarcane. We don't have anything for that stuff, so that'll be something that we'll have to work up to, I guess. We have auger wagon, we have header, we have forge, all that stuff. What's in here? Oh, we could use these little barrel. A wheelbarrow. Oh, look at that old wheelbarrow. Never even noticed this. This is all from Hofbergen, right? The milk shuttle. Barrow trolley, but we could use something like this guy. The old looking one is pretty. And then anhydrous ammonia. I have one set for that. I have the double tanker and the cultivator. So don't need a cultivator because the anhydrous cultivator. All right, well, as far as trucks go, We don't need any of these. We have a truck. We have a, we don't have a forklift, but we do have a skid steer that's at the shop. We have a telehandler, a wheel loader. We don't have a front. But the tractors are all set up. So that we just need to buy the arms. I haven't bought the arms. We got a mower. We got a slurry tank. We got an animal thing. We're not doing forestry, olives, or grapes yet. Although the first opportunity we have to plant grapes, I will be doing that. I think. Even if it's just a little ones. Not doing cotton or sugar cane, because first of all, don't really know how to do it per se, right? But what the best way to do it is. I'm not really sure why this trailer is on the IT runner. I remember I used to use that in 2017. FS, maybe 19. This guy's, right? Put these things on top there. But I like the Phoenix stuff now, so 82 Studio for the win. Hashtag whatever. All right, well, I can't really think of anything else that we need for this to get started. Just we need to decide what to do about this. Do we get rid of it, or do we keep it? And then if I do get rid of it, what do I put there? Seriously, I would have to drive straight through like this in the parking area and back up. Like this over here. Alright, so this anhydrous ammonia tank that's attached to the back of this cultivator, which would then be attached to the back of this tractor, right? It's like when you're trying to back that up, you can't back it. I don't even know. Can't figure out how to do it really adequately. We got the Elo rock picker. We have the roller that will push the rocks back down. We got a little baby telehandler over there. Kubota. Alright, we go mulcher. Gotta put this somewhere. Oh, up, fall off. Apparently this tractor can't pull it. I think it needs some front weight or something. Much weight for this bad boy. Arm work. That's sort of the problem with the Kubota. Jeez, I just constantly my brain is thinking to turn the ops. Alright, so that's the M8, M7. Kubota M8, M7, and M6. There's also an M5, but I need all this Kubota stuff from the Kubota pack. I mean, the sprayer looks great. Although, oh yeah, this one does have narrow tires. You gotta watch out for the narrow tire stuff, because since we do have crop destruction on it, we're definitely gonna want to use the tractor. The narrow tire, which is really none of them. We got our Fendt. Is this Fendt? No, yeah. Fendt Ideal Harvester Header Wagon. Header Trailer. This one's pretty cool. Like that. Next farm we do, whichever farm map we decide to do for a playthrough. I think I'm going to do an Xbox playthrough next, or in addition to this one, right? So I'll do a PC one and then an Xbox one. Maybe also a third one, a PlayStation one. If we do a PlayStation one, we'll do like literally no mod. The Xbox one, we'll just do the Giants mod. And then this one, just obviously heaven. Get another trailer here. I think maybe just exactly another one. Put two of them. Excuse me. Oh. I just put it in. Work is kicking my butt this week. Definitely lights in there. That's not nice. So, there you go. There you have it. Welcome to the farm. We are done setting up the farm. I don't know what else we need to do. Other than just getting started. So that will be our next thing. This just denotes, right, like high-end farm, right? millions of dollar op. Leave the X2 as maybe that's what I'll do. I have so many of these trucks though. It's pathetic, right? But I'll leave him. This guy with the auger wagon. And here, this way. This can be used for anything. So. Then we just buy one more truck because we just have all the toys. It's so fun to do one. Like that's basically the truck, but it's the modded one. So I have this one is the one with the whole has the Homer auger wagon on it. This Detroit diesel is which one is the Detroit diesel? Do I have three? Oh no, I don't. So the Winter Wolf is. One for winter. This one has the Homer wagon on it, so this one's actually like X3, I think. And then this map we'll use for deliveries. So then that means we actually do need one more. So we have an option of Detroit diesel, a cat, or a what's the CMS? I don't remember. I don't know. And then, of course, these ones are low. Does that mean they're quieter than these ones? I don't know. I guess we'll go with the Detroit diesel. We need an X3 configuration. RX2 configuration. Heavy hauler. I like the big fin. The rigid X2 is what you want to be able to use any of the attachments. So make sure you get that. I really don't have like the X2 with like sleeper beds and stuff. Okay, and then horsepower, we'll get the bigger one. Wow, there's a lot of different horsepower. Let's just go middle of the road. Low inertia, super 18 speed, 400 liters of diesel, 96 miles an hour, 14.3 tons. Real brand, Continental. I want Nokian Agriculture. Special edition. We're going to do a blackout edition. Seminole lighting. We're gonna go, I think we'll go red underglow. Bumpers, we're gonna put a big heavy bumper on the front. Yes. Mirrors. I don't want bow tie. Also because when I do in cab driving, you can't see out the window as well. I'll stick with that. Stock hood mirrors. Stock hood fender mirrors for standard. I like this one. OBS says no drop frames. 60 FPS. Seems like we're having some lag in the game. All right, stock hood mirrors. We want dual exhaust. I'm all about the dual exhaust. And I also like the ink. Flat first. Like. Stacks. This one. Yeah. GPS, will add that in there. Although it doesn't really matter, I don't think we'll be using it for that. We're gonna go with ruby red, aged with aged white or something. Frame we can keep black, the rim color was good. Achievement unlocked, vehicle fleet, probably because I got like 6,000 vehicles. Alright, that's it. We're done with this game. Let's go get them. beautiful looking dump truck. Also works very, very interesting. So tipper, water tank, or flatbed, wheel loader, nothing to use a wheel loader with. But this big ol' silage. I think it's 10,000 liters or something. I feel like it's big. Hey. Eight thousand liters. But yeah, that's pretty big for one scoop. 8,000 liters worth of silage. All right, well. We did a pretty good job for our first map, or whatever, not map build. Those are the modders. Those guys do crazy good job. That's not what we're talking about, but first farm build. Gonna have to do some B-roll or something. So dirty. Oh yeah, because I also have the freaking real dirt mod stuff added into it. Some lag right there. Closing that. Transitioning from here. We even got the oil state. And concrete. What do we do with this? What do we do? So easy to use auto load. To fill that up. Oh, it doesn't even really say how much does it hold. Like how many bales or whatever will it hold in there. 600. That's a lot of bales. Just feel a little bit. Doesn't quite fit the aesthetic. So we'll have to see how much bales we're producing. Alright, well, everybody. Thank you for watching the series if you have been. If you're new to my channel, maybe hit that subscribe button if it seems so fit. If you're liking the series, why don't you go ahead and push that like button. If you don't like it, make sure you push the dislike button twice. You're good to go. Yeah. Welcome to Elm Creek. Should be a fun series with fun, hard series with all of the add-ons that we're putting in for all the farming, precision farming, and animal husbandry and all of that stuff. Hard economy with, you know, $5,000 or $5 million debt, something like that. It's going to be crazy. Please, if you guys have any suggestions or any comments or any ideas or any help or any of that stuff, feel free to go ahead and put those in the comments comment section below the videos. I read all of the comments, so if there's something that seems like I need to respond to, I will. And if there's some tip or trick or whatever that you give, that I find useful that I can actually use to improve what we're doing, I will give you a shout out. So make sure you put them comments in there, because maybe you'll get a shout out on the video. All right, guys, this is Barnacle. Take care of my farming goblin friends, and we will see you on the other side. Peace out.